have a book. You have a book out. This is major.
Yeah.
Are you excited about this?
Or? Well, we've never done that before.
No, nope. This is the first book.
Haven't written much.
No, but this is bookofmythicality.com is where you can pre-order the book. Pre-order the book.
That's right.
Yeah. And of course, it'll be available everywhere as well. But this is the first time we're about to show the cover here.
We haven't seen it either.
Yeah. Is it good?
No,
I don't want to look
for this moment
until you show it to us.
Oh, it's good. It's memorable.
All right.
Here it is.
Let's see it.
From the creators of Good Mythical Morning, Rhett and Link's Book of Mythicality.
Bam!
A giant bowl of Cheerios. Now that is a great... How much fun was that photo shoot, and was it real, and was that a real giant spoon?
It's all Photoshop.
It's all Photoshop, but you actually are in a big hot tub full of
No.
It's totally real.
Every bit of it's real.
I'm just joking. Totally real. So this is actually based on something that happened to us in real life. So on an episode of Good Mythical Morning, we actually went to a cereal factory. That's the kind of thing that we do on the show.
Because I'm obsessed with cereal.
I enjoy cereal, too, yeah. Do you have a fave or a top three?
No. It's just cereal, man. If it's in a... it's bathed in a bowl of milk, I'm like, I want to get in there.
All right, calm down, first of all.
I didn't mean it like that.
The whole description was gross.
Yeah, that was weird.
It was weird, man. But you ended up going to a cereal factory.
Yeah. So, and while we were there...
Well, I got in the bowl. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, well, he's always had a dream to bathe in cereal. And so while we were there, we were like, let's talk the cereal... factory person into dumping hundreds of pounds of cereal and milk into a jacuzzi that we brought.
And she was like, you just assume they have a private room. Where like, you must have a room where you bathe in this, right?
Yeah. And so we did it. It was glorious. And we actually talk about that in one of the chapters in the book called Embrace Immaturity, which the whole book's about mythicality, which we call a combination of curiosity, creativity, and tomfoolery, the idea that you want to embrace those things in your life. As you get older, you don't want to completely grow up. So you do things like bathe in cereal. So we recreated that special moment on the front cover.
The book of mythicality right there. And did you think that, did you ever think that these dudes right here would ever write a book?
No, we don't look like...
Wow.
I have a lot of questions.
Yeah. We don't look like author material at that point.
Where were you? Were you at a festival or something, or were you at a mall?
This is the zoo, man. This is the North Carolina Zoo. Shout out to Asheboro.
Yeah.
All right, so you were at the North Carolina Zoo. You got the zoo shirts.
Yeah.
Well, we wanted to get a souvenir shirt, and nobody wanted the giraffe shirt.
And there were no youth sizes available.
So you can explain this photo, but then how can you explain this photo? What remotely...
You have questions about this?
I have questions about this because, this doesn't look like you're at the zoo anymore.
No.
No, we're just hanging out.
This is just last week.
That was...
Yeah.
Did you happen to realize that it looked like another photo of yours?
Oh, well, now that you put them side by side.
Yeah. I mean, your feet are even angled in the same way.
Yeah, it's all coincidence.
It's all coincidence.